He's gonna do it.
You want sauce too, Margaret?
Sauce, Michelle, breathe in on this hand.
Just dip it, my face.
Did I show you there was a...
That face is easy, I'm just kidding.
My face has got a broken,
More match.
Tailpiece.
I put it out.
On the string, see?
Hey, man, after this, I'll eat that.
Broke loose.
Well, I'm not just saying, Steve.
How about some more food, man? Would you like some?
No.
Michelle?
Gotta save room for the presents.
You got big pants, Karen.
It's too bad if you don't come and get some.
For dinner. Man, what's your problem?
You.
Shut up.
Make me.
I can't.
Where's it going, man?
So, you eat like this every day, huh, boss?
Yeah.
Son of a gun.
Hey, Billy, that's so nice.
I'm gonna graduate next year.
Yeah, next year.
Yeah, finally.
1 year from now.
Yeah.
Come get some, Mike.
All right, quit it, Steven.
Come on, Mike, this is Charlie Chicken Turkey.
Don't.
Don't. Michelle, get your face out of here, you're breathing.
No, it isn't. It'll make it.
Almost matches all on top of the wick. No, don't.
It's gonna make him in 2 days a week.
Yeah, without your mouth.
There we go. So what I tell you, man, I'm just stood, man.
That's it.
That face.
Wait, right
there.
Like flight stuff, and she didn't survive.
What's going on here?
All of this going on, and she's here.
I love hugging grandchildren.
And Molly, you got one more of that.
And since she didn't ask me, she wouldn't say this is not voodoo, whatever. That's just wild.
Well, he's even more careful now, though. He takes almost 45 minutes to an hour for each patient. Just reevaluating.
That's your boss?
Their whole chart. Reevaluating to make sure he hasn't missed anything. I mean, he's super careful now because of what he's been through. So now he's, you know, he's more empathetic with people that come in. He knows what they're going through.
Maybe she was a psychology major.
That's what I thought.
But anyway, she was saying, Maureen, you would not believe the weirdos that take this as a major, or whatever it was, minor major. She said, and you're going to go into psychiatry or whatever. She said, normal, the ones that go in here want to figure out themselves. They were so screwed up. They've got, you know, deep emotional problems that they can't tell.
Writer, copy.
wanted it to breathe, what angle we wanted to take with it.
I couldn't write anything.
In the public relations and the advanced advertising is the same thing.
And more writing.
Because you're kind of signing where you are.
My dog's been... It's safe right now, this job is safe. That's all.
Bingo.
Bingo.
It's not Clark's fault.
Stay on, Mike.
I hit the buzzer.
Yes, we can.
Your hair looks great.
That would probably be interesting.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Pretty good.
You really? When it gets too long, I just pull it out and I just... Cut this section off.
Great.
I know.
You really think you're my favorite uncle? Think again.
You're not thinking along the lines of the bricklayer. Come on, come on. What the hell? Here, what do you got? You got a guy who can't work for a living, so he stays in the service. Oh!
Yeah.
If you can't do anything else, you stay in the service. Well, why do you laugh like that? Right? That's a fact. Mother, is that true?
I serve my...
Yeah, that's true, honey.
That's right. There were no Viet Cong around Fort Knox the entire time Art was here.
Now, Art did good. He kept him away.
Did you see any Viet Cong around here ever?
No.
John, you were in service too.
Since you graduate from high school, the service is after you. He still gets letters every day from the Marines, the Navy, Air Force.
Good, hon?
We want you, you know, every day. Yeah.
Is that right?
That's a great deal that they've got.
That's a good thing.
Oh, they made it sound tempting.
What did they give you up to? What'd they tell you, Jenny?
But as soon as it begins to sound good, then we hear a 20.
War breaking out in Grenada, Eli.
No, you're not going anywhere.
The highest you can get is the Army. That's $15,000 that you get.
Mike, how about you?
So you said it was Spartan?
Another two. The cake is delicious.
You're a dork. So you're going to get outside.
I mean, a nice dork.
And you can bring them on.
And you'll be out of my... Dad sent you the chocolate one.
Look, graduate.
This is my new one that I invented.
Hey, good.
Good graduate. I get a little bit dream up.
Yeah.
But I tell you,
which is too young.
I told him it was good.
And then they go, wait a minute, so this is June 28th, 1967. That's right. Oh, we'll call you in reverse.
Yeah, but as soon as you graduate,
Well, you signed the letter so I could get in when I was 14.
Yeah.
You kept
Fort Knox, Kentucky City.
All you want.
That was the neighbors that sent the letter.
He kept the commies from Fort Knox.
We had a good skit down at...
Moving another chair.
Fort Leonard Wood.
You're good, Mike.
I saw the southern part of the United States and the Midwest, really.
That's right. Fort Knox, Kentucky. Remember that?
We went over there and came back and we were on the gold standard.
Me too.
I remember. Yeah.
We were on the gold. You were about this high, a little...
Good looking little guy.
You sure? You insisted on going swimming no matter what.
And you two kept wanting to get away in the car and I kept wanting to...
go swimming.
So we compromised. You were at the beach.
He was like Steve's age, and I said, let's go swimming. And Steve says, yeah, let's go swimming. Is that hot fish
water? Steve has some traits to go back on. Childhood there. Western pants.
Is he that kind of...
coffee, so they didn't offer me any.
No, does it on purpose. You go over on my side of the bed. And eat a cookie, and then if there's any crumbs on his,
he shuffles chocolate them over.
Chips. Oh. Chocolate chips, and he spits out the chips.
She's one of those that comes in about the morning, see?
Right.
She'll put on her jams and everything. Now I'll be in there sleeping, and she'll say, oh, a crumb! Everyone up, somewhere in this sheet. Oh, God, a whole crumb? She does her famous, this is another famous sheet, her famous prisoner escaping from Stalag 7, all the lights on.
I love to try new things.
You turn the spotlights on, the bathroom light on, the hall light on, all the lights in our room. Are you asleep? I'm just laying here reading.
Johnny, don't you want this?
I turn the bathroom light on. I turn the whole light on. I don't turn one light on in the bedroom.
Have you ever noticed that when I go to the bathroom, before I come out of the bathroom, I turn the light off so it doesn't flash in your eyes?
Right.
For fear of waking you up. And that wasn't the right word. I turn the bathroom light off before I open the door, just so it doesn't aggravate you.
Oh, God.
Tell me a story about how you used to tiptoe out in the morning when she was still sleeping and you tiptoe out.
Oh, when we first got married, I was aggravated with her. Yeah, I was aggravated. When Johnny was really small, he would keep me asleep. I would get dressed, you know, and I would kind of finish, you know, I was really aggravated with it. And when I got to the front of the apartment, I'd go, wham! Oh, wham! Oh, wham! And then you'd hear, wham! One day, she was so mad, she chased me through the parking lot of the I was honking the horn the whole time. Manager came out and he said, you're going to have to find another place. She chased me through the whole park. I don't know. I'm going to
Steve doesn't want to. Steve, you don't want anymore, do you?
Well, see, when Johnny was small,
Dad, did you eat?
And I would leave.
What did you eat?
I would give him a chocolate bag.
First time I tried that,
he'd stay there for another hour. But if I was aggravated, I'd only give him a few. Johnny didn't understand. So 3 or 4 microseconds after I reached my car, he would be upset.
You still like tricks, John?
Sometimes he gets out of bed and gets them now himself. You know, kind of that's true, honey. Why do you deny this stuff?
I didn't deny it.
It's true, absolutely.
Do you really bang the door here?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He'd be, you know, just really quiet away when he'd get to the door and just slam a couple, 2 or 3 times.
I thought he's making it up.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
See you later, sweetheart.
Yeah.
As soon as he's there,
they will.
One time, the cat got mad and grabbed his snoot and bit. And he was, he said, I'll show you how to bite.
Yeah, but the dogs.
Both of my cats really like the dogs. They're not overwhelmed with getting, all wet.
Yeah.
My black one, especially. My black one. Skip just in contrast. The cat even gets near me.
But that's fine. They didn't think I wanted to.